Hello, welcome to a look at Omega Quintet. This is a new RPG coming from the folks that brought you the Neptunia titles, Idea Factory, Compile Heart, Collaborative Works, and so on. This is their first foray into the PS4 as a platform. So it kind of interests me because I want to know what they can do with the new hardware as far as performance and everything goes. These games, or rather the Neptunia games, have been, or their series of games like Mugen Souls, Brave Fencer F, Neptunia, and etc., have always had trouble with performance, like frame rates and stuff like that. So I wanted to see if they can actually somehow make a game on a powerful system like PS4 and still have a lot of those frame rate issues. And they can't. They made games that look like PS2 games on the PS3 and still made them, you know, kind of perform poorly. But on here, on the PS4, they have successfully made a PS3 looking game that performs well. So hey, step up from the usual. I can appreciate it. But either way, let's go ahead and take a look at the variety of mechanics and what this game is all about, actually. It's a pretty interesting one, actually, because it's a brand new IP, and it tries to kind of go into a few genres that are popular nowadays. One of them being, you know, the standard JRPG thing, you know, which has always been popular. Even if it's a bit, they catered more towards the niche market, I suppose. And there's the whole idol aspect of it too, like Idol Master, and I know there's a bunch of other ones. I don't know them because I'm not a big fan of idol stuff in general. But let's just get right into it. The first thing is, this is the hub area. This is basically where you go pick up your missions, you go buy stuff from the shop. You kind of craft items as equipment. These are all just consumable items that I can make. And you need some items in order to get them. These are disassembled items that I've gotten from dungeons and stuff. So I just basically go to disassemble, and these are items that I've gotten from dungeons. And I just assemble them, and you notice that there are these Arcanium things on the right side. And that's kind of currency for each element, and I will need those in order to craft new materials and items and such. And it also gives me EP, which is the currency of this game. You can also do things like order outfits. This is just like a headband stuff. I've actually not gotten any of these because I'm not sure if they do have any actual like stats benefit, so they were not a priority to me. I can get a angel monocle, nose band-aid, watermarked. Why are they giving these girls monocles? Who in our idol group wears monocle? These are the five girls in the team. Kind of got like a Sailor Moon thing going here. But that's that. You pick up the missions here. Nothing too intense. Just go here, kill this. Go find this item. Use this skill and stuff. This is where you spend kind of like the endgame currency, where you get these coins in the world map, and you can use them to unlock new outfits, gain new chain skills and stuff. Chain skills I'll go into. Lowly Soldier Sailor Luna. Oh, let's see what these new items look like, because I have not bought any. Romance in the 3.5 Kingdom, Legend of the Sexy Ninjutsu. I have a lot of these coins, so I can probably spend some. Let's get Romance of the 3.5 Kingdoms. I don't know what that's around. I guess it's the Romance of the 5 Kingdoms reference, but let's see what that looks like. It's an outfit, so it's a kung fu wear. Okay, that's kind of cool. Ooh, man, it doesn't cost much. I'll just make it. Why not? She's the fisticuffs one, so let's give it to her. Sure, why not? It's probably not as high level as mine, but... No, as I thought, it doesn't have any real benefits. I've upgraded this several times, so that it has multiple amp slots, which are kind of like equipment slots for the item. But this has none. And then as you can see, the purple meter is the durability. When they lose the outfit, they lose a lot of benefits, so that's something you don't want to happen. So, alright, let's put that back on. Because, oh man, I lose a lot of SP, huh? Alright. The idle aspect of the game comes in from the theme, kind of. Because in this world, they are idols. And they are these things called Verse Maidens that fight these evil creatures spawned from these portals. Called Blairs, or Beep, as they say in, I learned some new moves in the PBS. So these are kind of like the place where you do the idle stuff. But I'll save this for last, because it's, personally, I don't really get interested in that stuff. The music's not bad, but I mean, setting up dance moves and etc. doesn't really interest me all that much. Let's go into the field and see what the overworld looks like. It's just like a menu that you go. These are all the red circles are areas that I can go to. And unlike Neptunia, the areas that you can go to are actually pretty big. I think traveling through one of them will take at least like 10-15 minutes or even more. So let's just pick one and get into it. Let's go to Yamata Town Ruins, because that's the new one that I just unlocked. And I'll show you some of the combat. As you can see, this is, yeah. No looking up skirts. I found that out when I wasn't intending to do so, but it's funny that it's there, I suppose. Yeah, I mean, the environments look alright. It's a very standard looking game, in all honesty. Oh, that's a treasure I haven't gotten yet. But anyway, let me show you how the combat works and how the, overworld. As you can see, I'm moving really fast. This is because I actually have auto run on. You're not supposed to move that fast typically. I also unlocked an upgrade that makes me run faster, so it just looks just kind of off. This looks like the right speed, but the run just is like you're Sonic. I wonder if there's even faster speeds. I've set the audio to Japanese, so I'll tell you the reason for that why later when the dialogue starts hitting in with the essence. So, I use an attack to initiate the combat. And as you can see on the right side, that gives you the order of the attacks that you're going to be able to do. And the number underneath the status icon of the girls, it says 4 attack there. Those are the actions that they're able to take. And, basically, for each number, you can do an attack, like 1, 2, 3, 4. It's pretty simple. But if you start adding skills to the mix, then things get a lot more interesting. Because the more combo hits that you do, the more damage you put out, obviously. And also, if you break them, you're able to do these things called Pursuit. And also increase the damage you deal over time as well. So let's do... let's do a Brillo Blast right in the middle. Get a couple of them in there. And we'll do a Flourish. And I'll do a Swallow Wings. And Berserker Assault on this guy. I've overkilled him by doing more damage than he actually has in full after knocking him down. So that's always nice. She has the ability to chain skills. You see how she has 18 above her 4 there? That's actually the attacks that she can do along with the protagonist of the game. So I'm just gonna do standard attacks, but I can also do pursuits. which actually gets the main character in and to do like a side attack, and also delays their turn too slightly, which is nice. And only she's the one able to do it because that's the one that I've linked the main character to at the moment. Pretty easy battle. The combat doesn't seem all that in-depth or interesting and when you first get into it, but once you start learning chain skills, you can really start doing some crazy damage. Let's go, I want to fight something stronger. These guys are fairly strong. Okay, it's just a single guy, but I'm gonna bring the pain on this guy. First of all, I'm gonna unleash this thing called Harmonix, which links all the characters that I have available into one single chain action. That opens up the use of chain skills, along with other various benefits. Harmonix, it takes up 6 of my action counts. And the action counts refill after each battle, so you can just freely use them, really. Harmonix mode, you see that now they're glowing. And now I'm able to switch between the characters at any point. Very easy to. And once I select a skill, you'll notice something pop up. Nope, not that one, I guess. Yes, it's Wolf Shock. You see, now there's a chain icon above Aria, which tells me that I can do a chain attack, like so. Now that becomes the Warrior Arena instead of the singular spell. But let's get crazier than that. Once you go into the skills and then you press square, you go into your chain skills list. This is actually a nice menu, and these are all the various skills available to you. And there are quite a lot, as you can see. These skills are determined by whether or not you have the SP to spend and the particular character has a skill. It kind of reminds me of how they did it in Chrono Trigger. If both of the characters are able to take action at once in Chain Harmony, or Harmonix, then they're able to do these attacks. So let's do a Warrior Arena, and it auto-selects the quest that you have for you as you press X on it. Easy. Let's go to the next one. And let's go do... That was a double attack. Let's go for a triple attack. Yeah, Empress Domain. Sure, why not? Let's go to Dry Sonata. Valiant Justice. Oh, wow. It's a 5-man attack. I have actually not seen this one. Cool. I must have just unlocked that recently. But now it looks like I'm starting to run out of actions a little bit. And I do want to finish it off with a giant attack, so Soul Poetry. Definitely want to try that out, but I don't have the actual resource to do so right now. So I can either do Tragedy. These are some powerful attacks here. These are special attacks, as in their ultimate attacks individually, and when you pair them together, as you can see, the modifier is 1,100%, which is crazy. Let's do Twin Melody. This is a good one. Actually, no, I should do that last to get the most benefits. So meanwhile, let's use their strongest non-super attacks. Aria should use... not that one. Is that the strongest I have? I guess it is. I'll use Death Sentence on her, and Kyoka, I'll use Lightning Blades. And now, only the two ladies remain. I'm just gonna do it manually, because I know what the skills are. Wait, can she not? Oh, is she out of SP? No, she's not out of SP. Alright, I'm confused. Why isn't that working now? Wait. Oh, I didn't cancel that one. Alright. That was a waste of time, but I know what I was doing previously. I didn't cancel one of the attacks that I was queuing up. That's why it actually took one of the actions away. Break Yourself. And finally. Queen Melody. Now let's see this play out. As you can see, the hits and the damage is just starting to pile up. Oh, that is some Power Rangers stuff right there. Damage in this. Yeah, it was over 100,000 damage. And the better you do, the more multipliers you get for your EP and your experience as well, so it's always nice to go all out in these kind of combat. But as you can see, you can get pretty crazy with the combat in this game, and I enjoy that. I always like combo-based fighting games. I'll do one more, and just to show you exactly what I need to be like looking out for when I'm doing the combat. Obviously getting surprise attack is always nice. But as you can see, when I get a surprise attack, all my characters line up nicely. But when you don't, or sometimes if you do an action, then your characters don't line up. So using things like defense to get them in the right area before you start doing your attacks instead of opting to attack. Because if I were to attack once, I would land up there. If I were to attack again, I would end up further down. Attack again, I'm down on the list again. So actually, I'll attack three times. And let's see, did I attack twice and then defend? Yeah, if I attack twice and then defend, then I'm still able to act before any of the enemies can. So that gives me an advantage. If I do that with all the girls, or if I do that with, you know, basically the timing of my attacks in mind, then I'm unable to attack and delay my turns to get them all lined up for harmonics. As you can see, the harmonics is the way to go for the most damage possible. So. Another thing that I can do is I'm able to use this thing called live concert mode, which I can set up actually. I can set up the song and whatever bonus that I've unlocked. Let's go to Voltage 1. This will start the... You basically play whatever song that you unlock that you like, and you have these... bonuses. As you can see, she got another attack as well as a bonus. So I'll do that into harmonics, and now my chain attacks will do more damage. Let's do down some more crazy. This time I'll focus more on the elemental damage because they have good AoE effects. I've unlocked even more I guess that's all I can do right now. That's fine. Yep, she's basically out of energy, so I'm just gonna smack things with her. I'll do one little tilt. Is that enough? I mean, I know it's more than enough, but chain attack. Wind attack. Earth attack. I think they're dead. Yes. Look at all those nice bonuses. Combo bonus, simultaneous defeat bonus, overkill bonus, request bonus, skill finish bonus. That adds to a healthy experience bonus. Ooh, look at that. 1123% approval bonus. Awesome. Let's go get that item. I actually like the combat in this game a lot. It's not an incredibly difficult game. It's actually pretty easy, all things considered, as long as you know how to use the chain attacks and such. But the moves look very flashy, and it's pretty satisfying to learn new skills. I finished this request as well. I don't know what the request was. Anyway, back to the office. And picking your time to get the most damage in with the right attack combinations, putting him into the right places, it's pretty fun. I like it. I think the combat is easily the strongest part of this game. And given that it's basically all the gameplay revolves around the combat, that's a very good thing indeed. And as you saw, the combat and the being on the field runs very well. I mean, there are a few instances where the frame rate drops here and there, but overall I think it's pretty consistent. I don't really care about whether a game is 30 or 60 frames or 60 frames per second on consoles too much. Especially in RPG games like this, I don't think you really need the 60 consistently. But it does a good job, and I'm pretty happy to see that Idea Factory Compile Hard, they've pulled it together for their first PS4 game to have a well-performing game. Okay, let's go into the whole story element of this game. As I said, these are kind of idols slash sailor, fighter, Power Ranger people. Haha. Yes, all the references. But they also, you know, have very quirky personalities, as typical of a Nisa published game. So let's go watch a bit of the story. If you don't want to be spoiled on anything, like, I guess stop watching the video now, because I'm gonna delve into some of the story. But this is, I think, chapter 6 or 5 or 6 or 7, one of those. So it's relatively deep in the game, but I don't think the storyline is that crazy or anything, so you don't have to really worry. It's just gonna be a bit of antics, some dialogue here and there. So I'm gonna turn in these two quests, and that should prompt. These are the quests that I did before. I think that's it. And then when I get out of here, I should get into a story sequence. As you usually have with these type of games, you can also set these things to auto. If you don't like listening or watching this stuff, you can just skip it entirely. But nah, I think a lot of the fun of the game is the quirky humor and everything, so So let go. Momoka. Yes. Guess how old she is. If you guess 17, you're wrong. If you guess under 20 in general, you're wrong. If you guess under 30 in general, you're wrong. She's like 37 or something. It's crazy. Anime. Anime, folks. Anime. Kana is kind of the typical airhead athletic girl, but she's fun.
これでよしと。さすが営業用の顔を作るのはお手の物ね。あ、しおりさんの調べ事は終わったんですか？
Kyoko's, I guess, the tsundere, I guess? Kind of uptight, but does good work. Nene's like one of those innocent looking girls, but she's kind of crazy. She has a like an obsession with guns. Otoha is the main female protagonist, I suppose. Typical energetic, not that great at her job kind of character. As you can see, I left the voice, or I changed the voice to Japanese. Not so much because I think the English voice acting is bad. I think it's fine, actually. I think most of the time, they get the same kind of people doing the same kind of voice acting, so can't be too bad. So they do a good job. But it just comes down to there's just more Japanese voice acting than there is in English. Like if you see any of the side events, you don't get any voice events in English. But in Japanese, basically every event is voiced. And I think characters are portrayed well with their personalities and what they're trying to do with the kind of character that they are and the way they speak. So I like hearing the voices, even if I, don't understand the language fully. So that's why I just made it Japanese.
ドキドキ。
They're called verse maidens. Kinda sounds like something out of Art Analogo, actually.
うまくいかなかったということですね。あ、そっか。ええ、少なくとも成功した事例は一つも残されていなかったわね。みよ。やっぱそうよね。そうだと思ったわよ。あなただから無理だったんだけどね。
どういう意味よ。そこ、喧嘩を始めないの。失敗に終わったのは事実だけど、状況が今とは違うのよね。状況？教会の付近はビープの密度が濃くて、マットも多い。一人？私は絶対無理かな。何度かなるんじゃない？それくらい。不可能だと思います。
強化でも難しいでしょうね。いちいち絡んでくるんじゃないわよ。まあそういうことね。実際にそこで命を落としたウタミコもいたようだし。え、死んじゃったの？愚かな。その前提意味があるんですか？
Takt is the main protagonist. He also serves as kind of the manager for these girls. He's kind of an aloof, very reasonable guy in a crazy world kind of thing.
So,
But there's something special about him too that the game alludes to. But he basically just gets dragged into this whole mess because of his childhood friend, Otoha, becoming a verse maiden. Yes, quintet. Five people.
だから毎度毎度聞くな。確認しておかないと。私が慣れたくらいだから。すま。大丈夫かはともかく。可能。あんたには聞いてない。私はね、ひいき目なしに。あなたがもう一人いれば、私も男の子を。Momoka
has retired. She's too old now. And as what age the power thief supposedly?
それなら、この子たちにできても不思議は。あ、ちょ、今の誘導尋問でしょ?簡単に引っかかる方がどうかしてるわね。だいたい、それは私が優秀だったからでしょ?半人前でも5人いれば2.5人前よ。マス。強化はもう1人前よ。んな、こりくつで済む話じゃないでしょ。
Indeed.
また始、私たち、まだ。え?ネネ、来ないの?え?だってものすごく危なそうだし。ね、アリアちゃんも。私は、どっちでも。She's
very soft-spoken and eccentric, but there's a reason for that.
本当の意味で町の人たちを助けられるなら、試しても。わあ、珍しい。強化。
Oh, and if you're pissed off by the pace at which I scroll through this text, get over it. Sometimes I go when I finish reading, sometimes I go when the voice stops playing. Whatever I feel. When you get the game yourself, and if you get the game yourself, you can do whatever you wish.
この試みが成功すれば、うまくいけばの話だろ。そんなこと言っても、タクト君も一緒に来てくれるんです。それはマネージャーだからな。よかった。では、あとは向こうの話し合い次第ですね。
ちょうど終わった。うわ、めちゃくちゃ気にしなくていいわよ。そうなんで、なんだかんだあなたたちをとそれよりごめんなさいね。いえ、勝手に盛り上がってしまったけど無理。もうそういうの。だからあなたたちが嫌だというなら、え、待ってる間に行く方。うん、みん、あら、
それはそれで拍子抜けね。危険は重々承知です。ここでボケっとしてるより何倍もいいもんね。The
thing about these games is that it's so lighthearted, so when they actually present real danger or any kind of threat, it's hard to take it seriously.
みんな喜んでくれると思うし。Also
worth noting that the last game I beat before this was Bloodborne. The change of tone is kind of extreme.
そこまで乗り気ではないんですけど、君はなるわ。そう、なら多くは言わないわ。ちょっとあなた、俺ですか。当然一緒に行くのよね。いざという時はどうするべきか。What
am I supposed to do?
前にも誰かに似たようなことを言われた気。さて、どうなるかしら。
That pet cat looking thing is weird, man. I think it's evil. Like all cats. Dogs rule, cats rule. But now I have my new mission to do. This is a training facility. This is where you go to level up your characters. You actually find some rather interesting items here too, like key items that unlock new chain attacks and so on. This is always nice. But it told me to go to the Arid Wasteland, so that's probably where I should go next. But instead of doing that, I'll show you some of the other stuff. There's also a makeup room. You can change the hair into any of the characters. You can unlock brand new hairs, hairstyles, eye colors, and all that jazz too. And sometimes when you're at the office, you want to wander around to see if there's any events waiting for you too. They are indicated by these little icons on the ground with the face of the character that it involves. And that'll start like a little dialogue thing. And you generally get an affection up for the character in question, like so. Level 3, level 2, level 3, level 2. This determines how well they work together once you pair them up with each other. And also, it determines what kind of ending you can get too. I've heard that if you don't get certain characters to like high enough affection levels, you can't get the true ending. And the normal ending is supposed to be real bad, so I do want to avoid that. You also want to do a lot of the side missions as well, which I have done every single one that I could find so far, because I definitely don't want to miss the true ending. As you can see, a new quest has popped up in the town. Just one. Okay. These side quests always take precedence over the main quest, because once you do the main quest and you go to the next act, the side quests may have very well been expired, and then you can no longer fill it up. So let's see here, where's that quest? Have I not? Oh, I already had the material to finish the quest. Haha. Lucky. You get items, you get approval rating, you get some EP. Easy peasy. The game has tasked me to go to the arid wilderness, probably the northern wastelands, but instead of doing that, I've shown enough of the combat and the exploration, I think. Or a lot of it, anyway. Oh, there's also like environmental stuff that you get, that certain characters can break certain barriers, walk through certain traps, open certain doors, and etc. But it's not that interesting. You just get the level ups as you play the game and fulfill the side quests. Let's go to PVS. This will be the last thing that I look at, because I think this might be a hook for a lot of the characters, or rather, a lot of the people to buy this game, because they like the whole Idol Master stuff. So let's just go and create a new one. Let's call it Vidia. There you go, that's how you spell Vidia. Spelling bee champion. I choose a song. I've only unlocked 4 so far, which is bollocks, but I'm sure I'll unlock more as I go on. Let's go with Move Mentor. I don't think that's how you spell mentor. Is mentor a word? Mentor? Mentor? I don't know. But let's go to edit. The intro cannot be edited because it's always the same. So you go to, there's these sections, right? Intro, melody A, melody B, chorus, interlude, outro. And you're actually able to go in here and change whatever you want. Change the positioning. Nobody likes you, Tila. You're in the corner by yourself. Everyone's on the right side, on the left side. Stay there. She'll be the outcast. Looks like, are they doing all this? No, these three are doing the same dance, these two are doing something different. You can select the character and camera. There's a lot of different camera angles you can select. Look at her all the way off to the side. Far angle. You can change the dance that they're doing. Energetic 2, 3. Dory, lovely dance. Okay. Risque. Yeah, so it changed the positioning already. So I wonder how it goes into that anyway. But as you can see, you change the camera angle, you change the dances that they do. You actually also change who's doing the vocals at a certain time, so kind of like lip flaps, I guess, and whoever it focuses to. So let's just go see. Let's see, incoherent voice. Incoherent. let's just go watch a sample one, I guess. Or I guess I could make a quick edit on the sample one. You can change the stage as well, like concert stage, I'm not sure. There's background, color, little display. I have no idea what the PlayStation camera is used for, but I can only imagine that it's something incredibly embarrassing. Where's that Kung Fu dress I have? Oh, okay. Only she can wear the Kung Fu gear? Interesting. Let's make this as goofy as possible before starting it. Yes. Yes. Everyone is doing the sumo move. I'm a great manager. Move two. Everyone is doing air guitar. You know what? Three air guitar, two air sax. Yes. Greatest concert ever coming up. Okay. Alright, I just changed a few things. I'm not gonna do everything, that's crazy. Shit, which one was I editing? I think it was this, right? Yes, okay, good. Let's view the PD. I love the whole thing. Alright. Okay, that's kind of funny. the song's pretty catchy. I like it. Fancy finisher. Sure. Gotta. I could basically make the entire song them just doing the sumo move over and over again. I'd be pretty happy about it, but ain't nobody got time for that. But yeah, that's the PVS. I have no idea what this does for the actual gameplay, but it's there. You can mess with it, and there's more songs, costumes, and like variety of stages to unlock, which is nice. But as far as this game goes, I think the combat is very enjoyable. Unlocking new skills. Oh, right. Almost forgot. This is kind of an odd thing, but it's here. This is how you level up your girls. It's a grid-based system, kind of like... And every time there's a grid-based system, I always make reference to Final Fantasy X, but... Surely there was one that did it before that. But either way, so it's like the spear grid. You get this one, you can get the next one, as long as you have whatever skill the prerequisite requires. And so on and so on. As you can see, I've counted mostly on fist skills for Kana. I've upgraded them. There's an upgrade for each skill that you get that I haven't. In fact, there's, I think, the next skill that I'm trying to get is it's like her ultimate move upgrade or something. But either way, each girl has a spirit grid, and all the skills are basically the same except for the unique passive and super attacks. But you can kind of build the characters to however you want, but at the same time it's not. The characters are generally made certain ways. You can, it's usually better to stick with the weapon to start with to some degree, because you know they already start with the with a proficiency. And I'm trying to get this next, try to increase her special attack even further. Modifier up by 200 is a lot. That'll be at 1000 modifier, which is actually insanely strong for an AoE attack, now that I think about it. Well, it'll cost more, but it'll do a lot more damage. It also decreases the weight too, which is nice. Yeah. I'll have to work my there. So I'll get... Okay. Spearstone, Legato. I don't have enough points for Ass Slot. Ass Slot increases my soft skills. It gives me another slot points for one of my magic damage things, or magic skills that I can only use. I'll give her. Revive's always handy, right? So you level them up through that, and you also level up your main character, or the male protagonist, but his is a lot more straightforward. His is based on adding action counts, so you can do more actions per battle, and also giving bonuses during live concert and whenever he's paired up with the other girls and so on. It's not bad. I think it's the only problem I have with this analysis is that it's super tiny, and you don't know what it is until you hover over it. So this is as small as it gets, and this is as big as it gets, and it's kind of like sometimes you're looking for a specific skill and you don't know where it is, and you end up just going, it's just back and forth for like a good couple of minutes just trying to find one skill. It's kind of annoying. If there was like a search functionality or like a sort function, that would have been nice, but I don't think anything like that exists here. But that's how you do the thing. These are the skills that they have. You change them around. The skills for the weapons are actually set after you learn them. They're basically it. That's what you have access to. You don't have to slot them in. I have every skill that I have for spear on Kyoka. Every skill for mace on Otoha and Cedra. So I tried to set them up with the right weapons and such. But yeah, as I was saying, I like this game. The dungeon exploration has been improved. It's bigger. There's more things to do. There's like environmental things to get over, kind of like Metroidvania thing. As you increase your environmental skills, you have access to more of the items and areas hidden away. I mean, it's a very rudimentary style of that, but, you know, it's still there. It's a lot better than what it was in Neptunia, which is basically just click square or whatever button to hunt for rare items, like one of each map, and each map takes about a minute and a half to go through, and so on. It's a lot more enjoyable. The combat is better. The idle stuff, I'm not a big fan of, personally, but I'm sure someone will enjoy it. And that stuff is really, like ignorable if you don't care about it really, so it doesn't matter. You do missions, you buy items, you go to training. But yeah, I think as far as their first PS4 game goes, they did a pretty good job. I hope their next Neptunia game, I forget what it's called, the PS4 version, will have the same performance, if not even better. Visually, this game could obviously look a lot better too. This is the PS4 we're talking about here, so this looks like a PS3 game through and through. But yeah, I'm enjoying this game. It comes out, I think, either like the 28th or the 24th or something in the States. If you like the Neptunia games and if you like what you saw here, then yeah, go feel free and pick this up. But yep, that's it. Thanks for watching.